Hi Aquarius, this is your forecast for the month of July 2017. This is a general reading for Aquarius Sun, Aquarius Rising, or Aquarius Moon. If you have a different rising or moon sign, you might find watching those videos helpful or more informative for you. You can watch your reading in three different ways: the full extended monthly, or for just the energy influence, watch the brief. Or in addition to the brief, watch the weekly for the upcoming week. Weeklies also make it easy for you to review information you may have forgotten in the full reading. Please remember that these are general readings, and so they may not apply to everyone. If you would like a reading that is specific to you, please visit my website at thealchemistastrologer.com, and I invite you to follow me on Facebook, Google+, and Instagram. Please also check out my pay-per-view channel, vimeo.com/on-demand/finding-love, for monthly love readings. Now, the underlying energy is the Sun, which is a wonderful card. It's one of my favorites, and it means that this month for you is focused on your ambition, your success, how fulfilled you are, and feeling optimistic about life. This could be a month where you feel empowered. There could be some prosperous development that gives you an advantage, and you have to make a decision about that. For some of you, you know, this is about energy, your health, and maybe you're trying to gain an advantage over something, maybe something medical. There could be a focus on children, on fathers, on authority figures, on life choices for you. Maybe you're dealing with prominent people, or you're dealing with intellectuals, people that are in the academic or scientific field. So this is going to be a month that offers some type of transformation for you. There's an opportunity for change here, the opportunity to follow your dream or make some changes in yourself, you know, take on some new identity or outlook. So you're going to be feeling good about yourself, and you're going to be looking at life in a more positive light. And in the process of trying to gain an advantage, trying to get ahead, trying to achieve something, opportunities will present for you. And you're going to have to make some decisions about how to gain an advantage. It's going to be important for you to be flexible about that, because those opportunities are also going to open up doorways that have challenge to them, and maybe more challenges than you were expecting. And so how you respond to that is going to be important. Remember, the Seven of Wands says we want to inspire, we want to motivate rather than make people feel threatened. And again, it's important to feel, to be flexible, to be open to new possibilities, and to put in that hard work to create the partnership that we want. So you may begin to have a better understanding of what your purpose is in life and who the key players are and what purpose they serve in relation to your destiny. This is going to be a month where you can attract good things, good people, good news, good situations, and you can wield influence on others. So you're going to be sharing, you're going to be exchanging, and being diplomatic, being objective and non-judgmental is going to pull great results for you. It's going to help you overcome challenges. And even if you are dealing with somebody who is Queen of Swords in the shadow side, you're going to be able to deal with difficult people specifically because you're using your good energy. You're going to connect to others that can open doors for you, give you good information, make you feel that you have somebody to rely on, a source of, you have people that are for you. They have your back. Now, regardless of what's going on, what kind of challenge it presents, because you are going to have some this month, still, the sun guarantees that there's a bright spot for you. The issue is not to push too hard, to take things slow, and not let how slow things are going be a source of frustration for you. You're looking for long-term results, not that immediate gratification. So don't let your eagerness to get ahead make you push too hard or try to unfold things in a way where it's just not good. Let things happen naturally. Don't allow your self-doubt to get in the way. And don't allow doubt to overshadow good judgment. You know, there's some situations you just can't save. Some people that don't need to be saved. Some people that you don't need to be going out of your way to impress, because those are just not good situations for you. This is also about being mindful of being narcissistic or arrogant or domineering or brash or impulsive or overbearing. And again, pushing too hard. Because if that's the case, you're just simply going to wear yourself out. So this is about diplomacy, being friendly, being non-judgmental, looking at other people's viewpoint, using your intuition to make good decisions, being fair, balanced in your judgment, having foresight to offset any potential challenges that are coming your way. Let any kind of frustration be a motivation for you. This is a month that requires some kind of change. And it's largely centered around recognition for you, whether that's recognition in a partnership or in business, or with the world at large. This is about your achievement, your place in the world, and your partnerships. Having constructive connections with others and being mindful of how you are allowing yourself to be dealt with in your connections. For some of you, there's going to be a challenging development. There could be some delays. Maybe there's a decision that needs to be made. But for some reason, this decision should not be rushed. There's a decision perhaps about how to gain an advantage, or a decision to defend yourself. Maybe this is something legal or medical or educational. But this is something that you're going to have to carefully think through. On some level, whatever you're involved in, somebody is working to, there's a strategy, and the strategy is divide and conquer. And somebody's going to take over a situation where maybe there's no resolution, people are at odds, and whoever this person is, they're going to take charge, and they're going to impose the law of the land according to them. This could be a situation where people are arguing their various viewpoints and there's no resolution. And while all of this is going on, somebody else is suffering in the background. In spite of all the problems, challenges, obstacles you might face, and however many things go wrong, that Seven of Wands is going to be your card to play. You're going to try to gain an advantage because there's a desire to get ahead, to stand your ground, or defend yourself, to continue the fight.